All right, we will now move on to the second presentation. The second team is Dot Inc. Please welcome the presenter, Mr. Eric Chuyun Kim.
Hello everyone, I'm Eric, co-founder and CEO of Dot Inc. In ESG movement, Dot is founded from a social sector and social problems. In our world, there are a lot of PWD population that is bigger than Europe or China and India market. More than 15% of world population has a disability. And if you think about their family and their friends, it's about 75% of our entire population. But the problem is, like you can see here, limited utilization of PWD population causes a lot of waste. For example, in the US, they're losing more than $600 billion revenue annually. Can you guess what it is? This is Braille Bible book. When my co-founder, Key, and I went to church, saw this, we got so shocked. We really like Silicon Valley innovation, but this makes no sense for us. One tiny Bible book becomes 22 Braille Bible books. And if you can see here, this one line, you can only read text in digital way, was the only solution about making contents available for blind people. And it costs more than $5,000. We realized that this problem is older than more than 30 years. And one of the most shocking facts for us was that more than 80% of blind population becomes blind their later ages, like 20, 40, by accidents or diseases. Because of that, not many people can read Braille because it's so hard to learn. They need alternative technology that makes go back to work and get more education. In our world, there are so many information are visual. Without visual information, you cannot live well. How can you understand these complex pictures by just hearing sound as a blind person? In EU, they tried to make a solution for this for about 30 years, and this is one of the failed projects. It's called anagraphs. And EU government announced that more than 30 million blind people need this technology to access digital information. So we found Dot, and we focused on technology first. Our technology is called Dot Pixel, created more than 10 times smaller and flexible size of display. Existing technology were really big, like a finger big, and we made it so small that can create a screen like what we see. It looks like this. And with this, we created the haptic visualization technology for every blind people. I'm going to show you one video about DotPad.
My name is Won Yun Son. I'm a teacher for the visually impaired like myself. The biggest challenge for us is dealing with graphical learning material like curves, charts, models, or any other visual asset.
While we're used to understanding complex topics through visualization, it's much harder for the 285 million blind and visually impaired people worldwide. Tactile books are expensive and rare. Audio descriptions don't work for complex topics. After 7 years of reinventing tactile devices for text, we're now entering a new dimension.
DotPad, the first smart tactile graphics display.
It can display any visual content from any source, because the innovative dot image processing technology uses AI to analyze and segment images and display them most accurately. DotPad's universal contour elements allow you to interact with the content directly on device. Thanks to our partnership with Apple, DotPad gives you access to over 2.2 million apps out of the box.
Being able to use all these apps creates a whole new perspective for me.
Instead of carrying heavy tactile books with the DotPad, we can now access anything on the internet.
You can take a picture,
and see instantly what's in front of you.
Wow, I've never felt my signature before. This is amazing.
Dotpad unlocks whole new forms of content for the blind. Games, comics, movies, and much more than we can possibly imagine. To increase our impact, we're already making the Dotpad technology accessible in other shapes and through other manufacturers, partnering with organizations, corporations, and governments worldwide.
They say a picture is worth a thousand words. Well, now I get it.
Well, Dotpad is in my hand right now. I put LG logo. More than 2,400 dots create a tactile screen for visually impaired people to see again. What we do is like what computer did to us. When you think about like Macintosh, when first computer came out, we used DOS system that only used text. But now we are using graphical user interface that we can interact through our eyes. But what we did to blind people is exactly that. And we are enabling education, enabling jobs, enabling entertainment. This means a lot, and this is life-changing technology. We recently got the Best of Innovation Award in CES in accessibility. Let's take a look how we enabling education. Through Dotpad, we can bring a STEM education possible to blind population. Let's take a look. On the left side, a blind student is learning mathematics through tactile books. And this is really old way. For 40 years, it happens like this. But with Dotpad, we make it digital. And we can create so many instant information. It is helpful for students and teachers. We recently made a $30 million contract with US government and brings Dotpad technology everywhere in US school. So it's happening right now. This is a picture that we got from the APH, one of our partners. So those books are translated to the pad. Let's take a look how the student think about it.
I think it was amazing. I've never seen anything like that before. When you're blind, you see images, you don't see them, but you hear about them, you hear people describe them. Maybe even someone draws something on a tactile pad to the best of their ability, but the tactile pad kind of brings it to a whole other level, and it brings the world of the blind to the world of sight. Combines the two.
We had a conference in LA. It was a 4 days conference, and she came every day. First day, she came alone. Second day, she came with her parents. Third day, with friends, and fourth day, with teachers. And eventually, she changed her future jobs. This is the reason that Dot is doing this work to changing their lives. How about rehabilitation? Like I mentioned, more than 80% got suddenly blindness through car accidents, through diabetes. So the rehabilitation part is extremely important for Dot. Through navigation, receiving pictures, reading books, it was not possible, but we are researching and bring our technology to the US military veterans. In the US, more than 130,000 blinded veterans are there, and they need a rehabilitation. So we are collaborating with Department of Veterans, and this is the picture that Iraq war hero Tim Hornick checking his daughter's drawing on the Dotpad for the first time since he lost his sight.
This exact photo will be portrayed on the Dotpad and what information? And I could definitely tell now that my daughter drew a rainbow because just the image quality between the two has changed dramatically by being able to have the extra information just filtered out. So, I mean, this is going to be a really cool feature when all this stuff is available, and I am looking forward.
How about enabling works? There are so many adults want to go back to work. But for that, we need to think about our daily lives. We are using PowerPoint, Excel, spreadsheet. And think about this environment. They need a screen. So we are doing instant changes of contents on Dotpad. And this is a video that we are working with Microsoft.
First, we'll show you the pre-chart demonstration. Display the chart to the Dotpad. And lastly,
right now, Excel data is instantly transferred in Dotpad. This is happening right now. And also, we are working with Apple. Since iOS 15.2 version, Dotpad instantly connect with iPad and iPhone and get all the visual data on the screen. And also, we are working with UAE government. How about the life of the Middle East blind people? So we are planning a bigger plan with the UAE government right now. If you think about like communication and creativity, you might know Andrea Bocelli, one of the famous tenor, blind tenor in the history. He invited us to his house in Tuscany, and we showed the Dotpad, and he loved it. So he saw for the first time his last daughter drew for him. And he did a million times of the signature, and he saw for the first time. So we are working with Andrea Bocelli right now, and Stevie Wonder. How about entertainment? A lot of people want to see sports game, and I'm looking forward to work with LG, how we can make accessible TV for blind population. So we are expected to be commercialized in 10 countries in 2023 this year and achieve sales contract of $40 million. And since 3 years ago, we wanted to see bigger pictures, how we can enable not just blind population, how about entire PWD people with disabilities. And we saw many problems in our smart city plan. We found out that there are no digital information and digital innovation happening in our smart cities. There are plans for accessibility, but there are no smart solutions. In the US, there are increasing AD lawsuits because of these reasons.
We wanted to bring barrier-free technologies to public services.
Fitted with a tactile visualization display, Dot Kiosk has been successfully adopted by the Busan City Metro System, as well as multiple locations in Seoul, including Yeouido Iram Center, Gangnam Sport Culture Center, Gangnam Public Health Center, and the National Palace Museum of Korea.
It started from really small movement. We offer to the Pyeongchang Olympic Committee, how about making barrier-free kiosk for Pyeongchang Olympics? But it was so early days, and we learned a lot. Not just for blind people, we are adding a lot of accessibility function for hearing impaired, language impaired, and someone who ride wheelchairs. So we created the fundamental solution for cities and buildings. That one solution is called Dot Kiosk. And right now, we are implementing in many places. One of the major places is the Busan Metro System.
Walk straight for 98 meters. He arrives at one of two accessible information kiosks that are connected to Bluetooth beacons placed all around the station. The system speaks out loud and has a braille touchpad that turns into a tactile map of the facility.
When I select a destination, the braille display lets me feel the layout of the station, and I can memorize where I need to go.
City officials say they plan to expand the app's coverage and install kiosks in all of the metro's 114 stations. The Busan Transportation Corporation's Jun Byung-jun says these accessibility features will benefit all commuters.
It's not just for people with disabilities. It can be convenient for pregnant women and the elderly. It has multiple languages, so even foreign visitors can use it. It's for everyone.
Smart.
I think the last word is really important. It's for everyone, not just for people with disabilities, not just for elderly population. It's for everyone. We are bringing our solution more than 100 stations in Busan right now, and we are expanding to the US and the EU rapidly. One of the examples is Vienna International Airport.
Mit unterschiedlichen Hürden konfrontiert, so auch der Wiener Michele, der seit 7 Jahren blind ist.
And if you think about like museum, for example, in the US there are 30,000 museums, and we need to make that museums also accessible. So we are having a POC project. We had POC project with National Palace Museum in South Korea, and bringing our accessibility solution for them. How about government buildings? Since we started last year, we planned more than 100 places, and this was unexpected growth, so fast growth for us. So we realized the market and the world need this kind of social solution. Global kiosk market is more than $20 billion, and a lot of studies saying about 15% will be replaced by accessible technology. Lastly, how about the future of accessibility that Dot dreams of? We want to make a lot of electronics, the best electronics that LG is making, accessible in a new way, completely new way. So one of the examples that we bring today is the remote controller. TV is almost inaccessible for every blind population. There are so many people in the US want to see, want to check. So we see this kind of population possibilities in the US and EU and rest of the world. And how about like kiosk? In every smart cities, we can collaborate and make accessible. And many blind people's dream is riding a car, having full control of their mobility. And right now, with one of the major companies, we are collaborating with making self-driving car accessible, even for blind population. And how metaverse, we can use our haptic technology to make metaverse accessible. With more than 120 patents, we are bringing this innovation to the world. We dream accessibility as a service unicorn startup and enabling every PWD population and become a leading company. This is a $50 billion market. It's not a small market. It can be a story about us. It can be a story about our family. Lastly, when we went to CES, we met US government people, and they sent this video for this Life's Good Award.
Hi, my name is Craig Stilson, and I run the Global Technology Innovation Team at the American Printing House for the Blind. I'm also a blind user of technology and a Braille reader myself. Over the last 40 years, we have seen a very stagnant technology world in the realm of tactile and Braille tech. Today, Dot has created a brand new cell technology that is going to unlock new form factors, designs, and innovations in this world of Braille technology. We're going to see people using, working, and learning with this technology in entirely new ways.
Dot is dreaming IPO to make a bigger impact to the world. Let's make now accessible together. Thank you very much.